sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. There he goes, left side. Touchdown. A great play there. 51 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And he floated one out there, incomplete.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him
to
do that?
I was going to ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film when it was to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Caught on the right side by Jones. Julio Jones all alone. And he will take it in for the touchdown. Julio Jones, 77 yards. And his guys get the quick strike touchdown. And sometimes those slants, they can be so tough to defend after the catch. It just happens so quickly.
And really, what gets set up there is how quickly everything happens. Ball's out of the hands of the passer in a hurry, and he just takes it and goes.
And he went all the way into the end zone. Here's Boscher to kick it away. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will finally catch him, but not before he gets it to the 11. Terrific run from one of the fastest backs in the game today, a guy who keeps defensive coordinators up at night, no doubt.
Remember when we were meeting with the D coordinator before the game and all he talked about was run fits, making sure our guys were in the right place so there were no creases?
They missed their fits, didn't they?
Yeah, there was no fit there. The only fit was at the end when he threw his headset down after that big run.
Off the play fake. Cunningham. And it's caught. Touchdown. Jarvis Landry, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And a great example there of just getting the feet in a tough spot. It seems like every year these guys get better at this.
Well, I think the drills get better that they work on, training camp, off-season work, OTAs. But also a lot of these guys have dance backgrounds, ballet backgrounds, and they take that and carry it over to the
pass. A one-play drive last time. See if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
true.
Time.
That's
I mean,
true.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And all the way down to the 24-yard line. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. So he wanted to pass it, but that thing turned out much better.
And the crowd really responded, didn't they? They always like it better when the quarterback who's scrambling around actually takes off and runs downfield. And that's exactly what he did.
And he'll be knocked down sideways. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Try to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. It's the 2014 NFL interception leader, Glover Quinn.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Throwing again. Cunningham. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So a minute 55 to go in the first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. On third down, Cunningham. Now they go screen. It's complete. Sanders shaking and baking. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And touchdown. A big play there. 92 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. So from back deep, deep in their home territory, all the way into the end zone. Do you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure they expected to score, but they also showed that they're not averse to taking a little bit of a risk there, right? Taking a chance, because the normal call is take care of the football, run
it,
be safe. Instead, they put it in the air and took a gamble, and it paid off in a big way. That wasn't an analytics call. That wasn't a fantasy guy's call. That was like a video game call right there.
It was a little bit of a video game call, but it worked. Bust through the tackle. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. And he's taken down deep in their territory. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Here's Young, operating from the gun, being chased out left.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Young now. From the gun, he'll throw, eluding the pressure right. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football. Let's go!
To throw again. Cunningham dancing to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep back over the middle. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. A handoff as they run the counter play. Room here to run. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing him further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
And that'll set him back 5. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears try to go for it on 4th. They'll try and throw for it here. Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. So we come upon halftime with 9 points separating these two teams. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy. The 30-yard line. Now Young throwing on first down, forced out to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to... That's caught inside the 20! And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. To throw on second down. Young, buying time to his left. And some space here. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Now a play fake here on first down. And some room to maneuver. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is picked up by the defense.
All right, let's be frank. You hate the fumble at the end of the play. But prior to that, I liked a lot of what was going on. Tucks it down, takes off, picks up good yardage. But in that portion of the field, that close to the sideline.
Step out.
Yeah, either get down or get out of bounds. Take care of the ball.
Yeah, he had the yards, but then the mistake. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Following the fumble recovery, Young flush to his right. Oh, he's got some breathing. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. To throw is Young on first down. Steps away to his left. Now he's going to throw deep back up. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 38. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
Man, we see a lot of quarterbacks try and do this. They get out of the pocket, they get in trouble, and they try and force the ball into their star receiver to make a play. Sometimes whether he's open or...
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Akeem Ayers. In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality.
There he goes, right side. And all the way in for the touchdown. A great effort there. 57 yards.